Welcome to this video where I will show you basics of CSGO HUD Manager by LexoGreen. This is just a quick start guide showing basics. Program have much more functions, but they are not critical to get stream up and running. Let's start. First thing to do is to download the manager in default HUD from the official GitHub site. You need to download both files. Open installation file and click through installation. After installation, manager should open automatically, or you can start it using desktop icon. Manager have 5 main tabs for managing games. Later we will learn what is every tab for, but for now we will start with initial setup you need to do after installation of manager on the new computer. Open browser and on Steam website generate API key to get players' avatars. Click those two buttons to set up the connection of the manager to CSGO. Last thing to do during the initial setup is to import the HUD we have previously downloaded. If you need a custom HUD or observer for your event, just hit me up on karolvitek.com. Let's start CSGO to better understand the settings we are gonna do next. We have to start CSGO through the manager to get it working properly. Those 3 switches allow us to set up if we want to use HUD custom radar, kill feed and so on. For now, use just custom radar. Other 2 settings are for advanced users and not covered in this tutorial. In manager, select teams tab and create new team. Teams are used to set up and track matches. Name your team and import the team logo. Then hit save. We are gonna create another team and get into our first match. In match tab, create a match, pick teams and best of series. Next important stuff is to set up pick and ban. Even if you don't use banning in your matchup, select map played as pick in your veto system, so the manager could track game properly. and hit it as current match, so manager can add map points to right matchup. Matches can be set it up in advance, so you can pick currently played as active quickly. I'm presenting Manager on a downloaded demo, but it works just same on live games. Now when game loads, we can see that default CSGO HUD is missing. That's right. If not, you probably didn't start CSGO using Manager, see Teams chapter. So when the game is active, in the live tab is an overview of players currently in the game. And now we are getting to the point why you are watching this video. In the HUD tab, we can open our HUD. But is device in Avenger? No, so there is a quick fix to switch teams in the match tab. It looks already good, but we have players' photos and we want to use them in place of Steam avatars. In live tab you can click to edit player, which will open players tab. And enable to add parameters like real name, country, photo. For now we need to close and reopen HUD to see changes. Let's add some more. Players can be added into Manager in advance by their Steam ID 64, which can be found on sites like teamfinder.com. Now we have complete Astralis roster, just last thing to tinker are those boxes. Boxes or panels content can be updated from HUD tab, setup icon. It is useful, for example, for changing tournament name, talent, sponsors. To push changes into live HUD, it is needed to press save button. This is an example how to set up basic OBS scene for broadcast. This is one of the simplest solution where you capture CSGO itself and HUD is added in OBS using browse source. Well, that's for today everything. If you need consultation about CSGO event production or looking for observer, I am open for business inquiries on karlvitek.com.